Hello everyone, my name is Alex. Skin shading is something that always seemed like one of the most difficult things to do right. But hey, I'm gonna show you how to create very simple but powerful skin shader in Blender Eevee. Okay, let's go. I already have some basic test scene here. Let me give you a brief overview so you can easily replicate that later. Say hello to my little friend Suzanne, she willingly agreed to be a test subject for our shader. I also have a classic 3 lights setup. I tried to put lights to match environment map colors. This slightly bluish spot right here is a rim light. This powerful area in front is our key light. Slightly reddish point down there is a fill light. Let me show you my environment setup just in case. Nothing fancy. Just a blurred HDR slightly rotated with mapping node. And I reduced brightness down to 20%. Okay, now let's go back to our Suzanne. Select it. And switch shader editor to object mode. We already have a default material assigned. I'll resize this window so we can easily tweak shader and immediately see the result. Let's start by setting subsurface value to 0.7. Wow, it looks so fleshy now. Should we stop at that? But of course not. Let's add some image textures to spice it up. I have some prepared already. Okay, let me show you what I've just loaded. Let's go to the image editor. Here it is. This texture is so creepy it makes me itch. High quality textures is a key to make a perfect skin material. Okay, let's return back to shader editor. Connect the texture we've just added with the base color input. We also need to connect it with subsurface color because now it's the main channel which affects colors. And with specular as well. Increase roughness up to 0.8. Now add second texture. This time it's a bump map. Let's go back to image editor and see what we've just loaded. Okay, this one. So in bump texture we have data about displacement of skin features. You can see that hairs are white on this texture, so they will appear sticking out over the skin surface. Let's go back to shader editor to put this texture into action. Now we need to add bump node before we can apply it. Connect texture color with height input. And then connect normal with the shader node. Now that's way too bumpy for us. Let's decrease strength down to 0.6 and distance to 0.15. Much better. Now, let's give us some control over texture size. Add input, texture coordinate node. Next add, vector, mapping node. Connect generated output with vector input of the mapping node. We also need to change node type to texture. Now connect vector output with vector inputs in both texture nodes. Okay, it looks quite distorted. Let's change texture projection mode to box. This way we'll have it map seamlessly over any mesh, and good thing is that we don't need to UV unwrap it anymore. We can play with scale values of mapping node to control size of the texture. Another way is to go to object menu, transform, scale texture space. Now drag mouse to change size of the mapping box. Looks nice. Now let's give it more fleshy soft look. Add color. Mix RGB node. Connect texture output with the first color socket. See how soft it just became? Now connect mix node with all the shader inputs we had before. I'll drop that line which just jumped over. Let's change color blending mode to additive. And set blending color to be almost white but with bluish tint. Okay, now that's too much. We need to add some kind of mask to control where we apply this color. Add input, layer weight node. And converter, color ramp. Now connect facing with the FAC input of the gradient. And its color output with FAC input of the color mix node. Let's change gradient interpolation mode to be spline to make it softer. Now drag this handle and see how it affects blending. What we're trying to achieve is to give soft look to those faces which are facing away from camera. Decrease layer weight blend value to make transition even sharper. Okay, I also forgot to switch bump texture mode to non-color. It makes it more precise. Let's also increase blending factor to 0.5. This value affects how seams between texture projections are blended in. We're still missing something. Can you guess what? There's one very important checkbox hidden deep inside material properties. Let me show you. Now it looks magnificent. Let's turn off viewport overlays and enjoy the final result. Remember I told that this shader doesn't require any UV layout to look good? But hey, what else we can apply it to? Let's try putting it on some Metaballs. Snap 3D cursor to the monkey, and let's delete it. Now go to Add menu, and add Metaball. Scale it down to fit in the viewport. Now I assign skin shader material. See how good it looks? Let's increase Metaball resolution. Now good thing about Metaballs, they come very handy in organic modeling. Just duplicate it and watch how it behaves. I'm gonna make another copy and move it down here. As I move one of the balls around, it reconstructs whole geometry and somehow looks so awesome. I just love how organic this looks with this shader. And it was so easy to set up. I mean, who else doesn't like to play with Metaballs? They look so soft and squishy. I forgot to mention that I also have ambient occlusion and bloom effects turned on. Perhaps this gives such a soft look to these balls. But anyway, there you go. Best in the world skin shader in just a minute. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you want to see more tutorials like this.